have you, always feeling you were there. And all my life I have searched for you everywhere. I caught your smile in the morning sun. I heard your whisper on the breeze at night. I prayed one day that your arms would hold me tight. And just when I thought love had passed me by, we met. That first look in your eyes, I can't forget. You melted me with your tender touch. I felt all fear and sorrow slip away. Now here we stand, hand in hand, this blessed day.
Face each other a little bit at least. Good afternoon, friends. Thank you for being here to celebrate this joyous occasion with Dan and Stephanie and to witness their exchange of vows. And we have friends that have come from near and far today to witness this ceremony. And I want to say to begin that I haven't known Dan very long, but we met him back at the end of December, and Stephanie wanted to bring him home, so to speak, to meet Mom and Dad. And so we got to meet Dan then and grew to like him immediately upon that occasion. And then to our surprise, we get a phone call from Canada on Valentine's Day, Saturday evening, asking for her hand in marriage. So we were so happy and honored to receive that call. Wasn't expecting it, and so we said, well, we'll think about it. No, we said,
they did.
Of course.
Sweat.
So here they are. Now, originally they were going to get married a little bit later in the year, but it kept getting moved closer and closer until all of a sudden it's like, okay, we're going to get married in a week on the 24th. Okay, well, we have a lot of things to do. But we thank all of you for helping out. So many pitched in to make this happen today. And so we are all very thankful for you and for your help. Now, Dan and Stephanie, you should look at each other. The two of you have come to me with a desire to be formally joined together in a covenant of marriage. And now, if the two of you have come to me with a, excuse me, next paragraph. Well, yeah, you gotta have a mistake someplace. Now, if the two of you, knowing of nothing either legal or moral that would prohibit you entering that covenant, wish to take his vows and assume his obligations, please indicate that wish by, I was going to say joining right hands, but you already did. And please listen carefully. Today you have high hopes and great expectations of ultimate happiness in the new relationship you are entering. I trust that you will find it. But you must ever be aware of the little foxes that spoil the vine and be on guard against them. Put your finest energies into keeping your relationship growing. As covenant partners, preserve sacredly the privacies of your own house, your married state, and your heart. Do not allow the sun to go down on your anger. Do not hesitate to seek good counsel from those you know and trust and have set a good example of a proven godly model in marriage. Hardships, testings, and trials will come your way over which you have no control. You do, however, have control over your own spirits and how you will react to the pressures and stresses of life. These can strengthen your marriage or undermine it. Cultivate the fruit of the Spirit: love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. It will stand you in good stead. May your home, in which you have time for each other, be not only a place of continual joy to you, but may it be, too, the source of constant glory to God. Let me suggest early that you set up a family altar as the center of your home. Read God's word together, pray together often, learn early in your married life that the best place to solve your problems is on your knees. Dan, Stephanie is giving herself to you today. Established as a chief priority of your life, second only to pleasing the Lord, loving her, and making her happy. I urge you to live so closely to the Lord that you will never do anything to bring her sorrow or make her ashamed to bear your name. Above all, be the spiritual leader in your home. Stephanie, you are taking Dan as your husband today. Follow where he leads you. Always give him respect. Never belittle him. Always be the one to say, "Dan, you can do it." Believe in him, encourage him, and he will amaze you with his feats of accomplishment. Be his number one supporter in life, and each day intercede for him before the throne of grace. Dan and Stephanie, always cultivate that thrill of romantic love and the attraction that drew you together in the first place. Never cease being sweethearts and best friends. Walk arm in arm with each other and with your Lord. Now, in token of the fact that you have freely and deliberately chosen each other as covenant partners for life, give heed to the questions I am now going to ask you. So, this is where you wait till the end. Do you, Dan, take Stephanie, whom you now hold by the hand, to be your true and lawful wife, and in the presence of God in this assembly, do everything in your power to make your love for her a growing part of your life? Will you continue to feed your love for Stephanie from now on from the best resources of your living? And will you stand by her in all of life's situations, in sickness and in health, in poverty and in wealth, in the shadow of life's darkest moments, as in the sunshine of joy-filled days? And will you not give yourself to her, all that you are and all that you possess? And as a faithful husband, will you shun all others and keep yourself to her alone until together or separately you meet your risen Lord?
The answer is yes.
Okay. All right. Stephanie, do you take Dan, whom you now hold by the hand, to be your true and lawful husband? And in the presence of God in this assembly, do everything in your power to make your love for him a growing part of your life. Will you continue to feed your love for Dan from now on from the best resources of your living? And will you stand by him in all of life's situations, in sickness and in health, in poverty and in wealth, in the shadows of life's darkest moments, as in the sunshine of joy-filled days? And will you now give yourself to him, all that you are and all that you possess? And as a faithful wife, will you shun all others and keep yourself to him alone until together or separately you meet your risen Lord?
The answer is yes.
Okay, the answer is yes. All right. Dan. Repeat after me. I, Dan.
I, Dan.
Take you, Stephanie.
Take you, Stephanie.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
In prosperity and adversity.
In prosperity and adversity.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
And I give myself to you.
And I give myself to you.
All that I am.
All that I am.
And all that I possess.
And all that I possess.
Until together or separately.
Until together or separately.
We meet our risen Lord.
We meet our risen Lord.
And to this covenant.
And to this covenant.
I pledge you my faithfulness.
I pledge you my faithfulness.
Okay, Stephanie, repeat after me. I, Stephanie.
I, Stephanie.
Take you, Dan Olsen.
Take you, Dan Olsen.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
In prosperity and adversity.
In prosperity and adversity.
In sickness and in health.
Sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
And I give myself to you.
And I give myself to you.
All that I am.
All that I am.
And all that I possess.
Until together or separately,
we meet our risen Lord. And to this covenant, I pledge you my faithfulness. In the Word of God, it is written that when God established a covenant with Noah, he gave the sign of a rainbow. As you are entering into a sacred covenant today, it is appropriate that you set aside signs of that covenant, that you may see them and remember the vows you have made. The rings you're about to exchange are the signs with which you will seal your marriage covenant. Okay. Well, I got both of them. Hold on to that one. I want to encourage you, when you get a chance after the ceremony today, look at the ring, beautiful rings that they have. And the color of the ring is emerald, which represents both of their birthstones, where their birthdays are 1 week apart in the same month in the same year. So they're very, very close in age. And there are eight is the number of new beginnings. And there are eight emeralds and eight diamonds on this ring. And then in the center of the ring, there is a large emerald, which represents God as the center of their relationship, center of their marriage. So, Dan, take that ring, and you know which finger to put it on?
I'm dyslexic.
she knows which one.
I got it.
So what you do is you put the ring about halfway on and just hold it there and look at her, and you're going to repeat after me again. Let's see. I gotta find this. No, wait a minute. Okay, sorry. He's putting the ring on there. You're looking at him. You're gonna respond first, okay? All right. It's been a long time since I've done a wedding. So. All right. With this ring. Oh, I'm sorry, Dan.
Wait a minute. I say this.
Yeah, you say this.
I'm
go ahead.
Saying this.
I'm with this ring. Okay, with this ring. I solemnly seal. My marriage to you.
My marriage to you.
I give it as a sign.
I give it as a sign.
Of my covenant of love.
Of my covenant of love.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
And now, all the way on there. Okay, now I need the other ring. Okay, you got it on? Does it fit?
There we go.
Yeah.
And there's Dan's ring. And get it set up there. Okay.
With this ring.
I'm. Yes. Will you, Dan, receive this ring as a sign of Stephanie's affection, sincerity, and faithfulness in her vows to you? And will you wear it as a sign of your own affection, sincerity, and faithfulness in your vows to her?
I will.
Okay. All right. Now, we're going to repeat after me,
okay?
With this ring, I solemnly seal
my marriage to you.
I give it as a sign of my covenant of love. In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Holy Spirit. Of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Okay. Now, Bishop, then rejoin your, join right hands. Right hand. There you go.
The other
right.
The other right.
Okay. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. Be eager in the pursuit of the love of which these rings are tokens. For the union now formed is to be ended only by death or being caught away to meet our heavenly bridegroom when Christ comes for his own. Dan and Stephanie, having made a marriage covenant, look at each other. We didn't practice, so.
That's scary.
Yeah, don't look at
me. Don't look at me.
Look at him.
You're marrying him. Dan and Stephanie, having made a marriage covenant before God and these assembled witnesses, pledging your faith in and love for each other, and having sealed your solemn covenant vows of marriage by the giving and receiving of rings and by joining hands as a minister of the gospel, I take great pleasure in using the authority vested in me by the word of God and by the laws of the state of California and looking to heaven for divine sanction. I declare you to be husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man separate. I charge you to take care in the sight of God that this holy covenant shall ever remain sacred and that these vows shall never be broken. And now, may the God of peace prosper and bless you in this new relationship, and may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ abound in you now and always. In celebrating your covenant marriage, we will now remember the greater marriage covenant, that of our heavenly bridegroom, the Lord Jesus Christ, with his bride, the church. He has instituted the memorial celebration of the Lord's Supper in remembrance of his body and shed blood by which he established his covenant with us. As you partake, you reaffirm your marriage covenant by the covenant you both have with Jesus and our Heavenly Father. Lord Jesus, we ask that this bread be blessed as these two are now united in marriage. Let it be a sign of their agreement that this marriage covenant shall not be broken, even as your body was not broken. May they accept it as a sign that your healing power and love is always available to them throughout their life together. And then you take both pieces, give her one. Go ahead and eat. Lord Jesus, we bless and sanctify the cup as a reminder of the awesome power of your blood to bring them into a perfect covenant of salvation with you, and that their covenant of marriage is based upon the greater covenant established by your death and resurrection. Amen. Jesus said, as you eat and as you drink, you are remembering my body and my blood, which was given for you. So you sit first, and then give her a sip. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen. Would you bow your heads with me as we offer a prayer? Yes. Oh, I'm sorry. Yes. I skipped something.
Yes.
The answer is yes.
They have vows to give to each other. So before we continue with the prayer, but yes. We shouldn't practice this, you know. Turn it on.
I like winging it.
You like winging it? Okay. Okay, we got it on, Joel. Microphone. Yeah, that's fine.
Check.
Dan, I never imagined that I could love someone the way that I love you. From our first conversation 4 years ago, I knew my life would never be the same. When we parted ways 3 years ago, I prayed for God to clean you up and send you back. And just 95 days ago, you reappeared in my life. You were the same man who stole my heart back then, but now you had a new outlook on life, the world, and your soul. You're transparent. You were vulnerable and walked in a level of integrity that has melted me and drew me to you. After 300 hours of phone conversations and 20 days of being together face to face, I know without a doubt that you are the only person that I want to spend the rest of my life with. You honor me in a way that I never knew possible. The day that you called John and Judy and asked for permission to marry me, I was certain you were the man that God had called to me. I promise to always put your needs before my own. I promise to wake up every morning with the desire to make your day better. I promise to give myself to you wholly and without reservation. I promise to love you unconditionally. I promise to pour your coffee first. I promise to be a safe place for you to share your hopes, your dreams, and your fears. I promise to honor, edify, and love you all the days of my life.
The other one there. Oh, I see. Oh, you got it. Okay.
Stephanie, God brought us into each other's lives 4 years ago to introduce us to one another. He knew there was work to do in both our souls, but he wanted to give us something to work for. The fact that we are standing here today is nothing short of miraculous. It is the most powerful testament of God's presence in my life that I have ever had. Our story is a true love story that only you and I know all the parts to, culminating to me asking John and Judy's permission to marry you just 10 days ago, and a wedding with PowerPoint and live streaming video today. Now, anyone who knows Stephanie knows how we can have a wedding with a PowerPoint presentation and live streaming video in 10 days. Amen? Yeah. Amen? I read a quote recently that said, "Fall in love with a woman's soul, and you'll be in love with that one woman for the rest of your life. Fall in love with the flesh, and 1,000 will never be enough." In the last 95 days since we were reunited, we have spent hundreds of hours talking on the phone, falling in love with each other's souls. How is it possible for me to know that I want to marry you in 95 days? I fell in love with your heart. I fell in love with your soul, always and forever.
I don't need this.
Okay, we're going to pray. So if you'll just agree with me now as we offer a blessing, a prayer of blessing over this couple. Father, I thank you for Dan and Stephanie today. I thank you for the pledge that they made to each other. I thank you for the call of God that's on this couple. I thank you for the destiny that is set before them, that as together, husband and wife, they go forward together, arm in arm, as warriors in the kingdom of God. And I ask, Father, for a special impartation of wisdom, wisdom in their relationship with each other, wisdom to do the work of the King, the work of the kingdom. And we just bless them that they will be in good health, that they will know how to stand and take authority in the name of Jesus over everything that the enemy tries to throw against them. They will walk victoriously. They will not lose a single battle because the battle has already been won. The war is won. All they have to do is walk it out. So we thank you, Father, for blessing them and covering this couple in the name of Jesus. Amen. Do you want to say anything? Okay. You know, you may now kiss the bride.
Woo!
I think they've had some practice. All right. Let's do it again. Okay. Face the audience. Get ready to go. I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Dan Olsen. Punch and coffee reception and a fellowship on the back. You may greet them as you go out.